Welcome to Michael and Debbie's wedding.
But I got lost in time or two. Wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. That every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. Smile, take my hand. You've been there, you understand. It's all part of a grander plan that is coming true. Every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars.
Amen. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Amen. Amen. To everyone that applies to, you may be seated. I want to read some verses of scripture for us this afternoon. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8. The Bible says this: love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own good, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. And that's what we call this today. Love never fails. Michael and Debbie and every dearly beloved here, I'm glad to share this day with you. And I'm happy that God has a plan for these two, for everybody here. So let's pray as we get started here. Father God, today I just want to thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for this couple and every loved one here. And we pray that as we all trust you, that we're going to see we're never going to be disappointed. Bless our time together today that you might be first place. And it's in the name of Jesus I pray. Amen. So the verses I read, they talk about that awesome, selfless love that's all our goal. And so the first wedding that I was a part of many, many years ago, back in 1989, I was the ring bearer. I had to bear those rings and take care of them. And I had that one job to do, and I tried so hard. I tried with all my might, my little six-year-old might, to keep those rings. But unfortunately, I was young, and I was distracted, and I lost the rings. As sad as it was, I had to get some help to go find them. So it was a sad time. We still had a good wedding, but it was a sad time because I felt like I let everybody down. I felt like that I had failed. And my point in saying that is we all fail at different points. We all mess up in different ways. But we talk about that love that never fails. Well, how is that? Because I want to emphasize to us today that that love is not just floating out there, but we need someone to show us who that love is, what that love really is about. And Michael, I hadn't known you super long yet, but it's been good getting to know you. But Debbie, I've known you for a good little while. It's been a goodly number of years. And some of my earliest memories of seeing you, being here, were way back when you and I were both a lot younger. And you were here at the church, and little Stevie was really little Stevie. And he was a little baby wandering around here. And who was there to follow him around and wipe his mouth from all the church dinners that was here? It was you. You were showing him that love as a person, as an individual. And so that love isn't just sitting out there in space somewhere. That love comes through a man. His name is Jesus. Jesus gives us that love that no one else could ever give, because the rules don't teach us love. He does. Jesus came to earth to show us that. And I know that for sure, that when I was a mess, when no one would have taken me, when I was a failure, Jesus loved me. He loved me and he was willing to save me. And how do I know that? He was willing to get messy and die on a cruel cross for my sins and for the sins of everybody else here and everybody else that's watching on the internet. By the way, we're glad you're watching out there. How did Christ love? He showed us by giving everything to us. In Luke 23:34, the very people that put nails in Jesus' hands and in his feet, what did he say about them? Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing. They don't know what they're doing. What kind of love is that? He came himself to show us what that love is. And I want to say to Michael and Debbie today, marriage is messy. Marriage is messy. And you may feel like there's times that you failed, but his love never fails, because God will love you through the mess to make it a masterpiece. And I just want to encourage you that this is the beginning of something that touches many lives, that God has a plan. Oh, there's so much potential in these two. Michael, you have an infectious laugh. Did you know you have a laugh that everybody catches when they hear it? And Debbie, you have some strength in your character. You have strength. And the reason I say that is for this. We need to be praying for these two, that God will show them just exactly all their potential and all that God has for them, because there's something good that he has, and that's our job to pray for that. And I want to say this in our brief time that I'm sharing here. The best decision that they'll ever make, it's actually not with each other. It's not the best decision. That's true for any of us, too. The best decision that we'll ever make is whether or not to accept Jesus' love and to accept him as our Savior, because he loves us like nobody else ever could, and he wants to know us. And I pray that everyone in here find God through Jesus and love him beyond the failures, because his love never fails. That no matter how far down we think we've gone, he'll grab us up and pull us up when we turn to him. And so I won't say the altars right here are full right now, so we can't do an altar call, but I want to say this. Make an altar soon and make sure everything is where it needs to be with Jesus. Because I tell you what, he shows that love by coming himself for us. And so don't let anything that life throws you convince you that you have failed. The only way you really ever fail is if you fail to find Jesus. Find him. He loves you. And I pray for each one of us today and everybody that's listening to this today, Jesus loves you. All right. I encourage Michael and Debbie, if they want to join and face each other now. At this time, Michael and Debbie have personalized vows that they want to share with each other.
I'm not getting on the speaker.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are, because you've got my answer here. Practice, okay?
Debbie, I love you from the beginning to the end. When I first saw you, I finally found someone that understands me, cares about me, and loves me. And I love you for the rest of my life.
Amen.
Michael, I promise to love you unconditionally from to infinity and beyond. When it's hard, I promise to have your back and that you never have to walk through anything alone again. I love you with all of me for the rest of my life.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. May this wedding today remind both of you that no matter what life throws, you and all of us won't quit loving God, and you're going to find the love of God together more and more every day. All right. So now it's time for the vows. It's time for it. Y'all ready to go? We're going to do this. Michael, will you take Debbie as your lawfully wedded wife to live in God-ordained holy matrimony, encouraging her always toward God's plan?
I do.
Amen. Do you affirm your love for her? And will you love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And now, Debbie, will you take Michael as your lawfully wedded husband to live in God-ordained holy matrimony, encouraging him always toward God's plan?
I will.
Do you affirm your love for him? And will you love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do, even when you tell me I can't go to Five Below.
Amen. Amen. And now it's time for the rings. It's time for the rings. Rings are that reminder of God's circle of love. And so, Michael, if you want to go first. And so just repeat this after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed you, Debbie.
I wed you, Debbie.
Place the ring on her finger. Yes. Amen. I heard that. All right. And now, Debbie. All right. So repeat this after me, Debbie. With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed you, Michael.
I wed you, Michael.
Praise God. Praise God. All right. So now let's pray again as we get ready to move forward here. Father God, I pray you bless this couple as we shared about today. Remind us your love never fails to each one of us. Drive that home in our hearts. As we go forward, may we put you first to do good to everyone and show that love in good times and in bad. And help Michael and Debbie and all of us here that, Lord, that commitment to love you, Lord Jesus, will always grow. And it's in that holy name I pray. Amen. So now, by the authority vested in me, you are now pronounced husband and wife. Please celebrate these vows with a kiss. Praise God. Praise God. Let's face everybody. If you'd face everybody, please, here with this. So, and y'all correct me if I'm wrong, but all are invited to stay for the reception today, but it's asked that you wait until after the pictures are completed before the food is served. Is that right, Debbie? Just going to set it up now? Okay, so it's time for the food then. Is that right? Yeah. All right, we're going to dig in, so everybody's invited. So it's with pleasure that we conclude this marriage ceremony. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Debbie Chambers. Amen. Praise God. For all on the internet, we love you and we pray God's blessings for you. For all those out there on the internet, we love you and we'll see you soon at Christian Life Assembly. God bless you.